Hi, I'm Carrington Payne from Fame, and you're watching Hawk Talk.
Good morning, El Dorado. I'm Kelly Hugribe.
And I'm Tony Sherg, and welcome to Hawk Talk.
Hey, Tony, do you think you can dance?
No, but I heard EDHS alumni Carrington Payne can.
That's right, and here's Brianna Cuesta with a story on the rising star.
Hi, my name's Brianna Cuesta, and I got a chance to meet Carrington Payne from the upcoming movie Fame. Let's see what she had to say.
Hi, I'm Carrington Payne from Fame. I've been dancing since I was 2, so this has always been a passion of mine, and I never wanted to stop, and always knew I wanted to be a professional dancer. I went on a show called So You Think You Could Dance, and from there, filmmakers from Fame saw me and wanted me to audition and see how my acting skills were. I went, you know, straight from being on So You Think You Could Dance in front of cameras and everything, and so, you know, moving into a whole different level of, you know, performing and acting for the cameras. Fame is the perfect movie for people to get inspired. It totally has that message. Alice is the aspiring dancer in the film, and I guess you could describe her as kind of the girl who has everything. She's rich, she's beautiful, she's the most talented girl in her class. I'm an aspiring dancer, so my whole life I've been focused and driven to dance, and same with her. Fame has been another great experience. Me and the cast, there's 9 other people, we became really close friends, and yeah, I could call them like my second family now. It was amazing being in that industry and working with the crew, the cast, everybody just meshed really well together, and it was just a really good experience. I'm helping coach the dance team right now, an assistant coach. So that's really exciting to be, you know, back at school and helping the dance team that I was on. But other than that, just trying to pursue my acting career and hopefully get more jobs, and hopefully Fame opens some doors.
In other news, here are the sports.
Last week, El Dorado played the Fullerton Indians, defeating them by 6 points, 27-21. Quarterback Andres Umbuel passed 145 yards, and Brock Dunn rushing 147 yards. And Hawks, don't forget, the Bell game is this Friday at 7 o'clock. Be there!
Girls golf suffered a devastating defeat by 13 strokes against the Barrio Linda Wildcats, 230-217.
Boys water polo demolished the La Habra Highlanders, 14-5. Alex DiBartolomeo showed his gills with 7 goals, 7 steals, and 1 assist. In the girls breast cancer volleyball game, El Dorado lost 3-1 against MiraCosta. Andrea McHugh had 24 kills, and Gracie Gallardo had 33 assists. And speaking of volleyball, they don't only devour the court, they also fight crime.
So are you really excited for Notre Dame fans?
Yeah, I'm excited, but about Viola?
Oh. Come on, punk, short stuff. Hey, I think it's time to take out the trash. What do you think?
Why is this happening?
Oh my God, somebody do something!
You see what I see?
Yeah. Set me.
We'll be right back.
fall play coming up, here's a story about what to expect.
EDHS Theater will be performing the fall play next week. We talked to theater teacher Mrs. Switzer to find out more.
The Art of Rejection and Chaired are two one-act plays. The Art of Rejection is basically about the repercussions that come from somebody feeling rejected and left out. And Chaired is about finding the freedom to be able to take risks. And both of them are sort of artistic, abstract plays that don't really follow a linear plot line.
People should come see this play because everybody's able to relate to it. Everybody at one point or another has been teased. Everybody at one point or another has been held down, afraid to take a risk. And that's really what both plays are about. So everybody's able to relate to it on an emotional level.
The main character in The Art of Rejection is played by Rod Bagheri, and the main character in Chaired is played by Nicole Glenn. And then both plays involve 11 other members of Thespian Troupe 199.
I want you to see The Art of Rejection and Chaired.
Here are your
announcements!
If you are interested in helping out backstage with any of the theater department productions, this year join Encore Club. There is a meeting today and lunch in the theater. Aloha, El Dorado! Ticket sales will be extended through today for the Aloha Dance. Be sure to be there on Saturday. There is an FBLA meeting for all former members this Friday in room 510 at lunch. To all girls interested in trying out for the girls' soccer team, the tryouts are Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday at Wagner Elementary School from 3 o'clock to 4:30. Download the paperwork and turn it to the finance office. If you were a member of the Creative Writing Club last year and are interested in becoming an officer, come by room P29 today at lunch. This is for past members only. Yearbook wants your photos. We are looking for you, your pets, your jobs, your non-school sports, and your summer trips.
Pre-sale tickets are on sale now. Adults and students without ASB are $8. Children in grades kindergarten through 8th are $3. El Dorado students with ASB imprints get in free.
Want to join the funniest team in town? Well, Comedy Sports, an improvisational theater group, will be having a meeting Friday the 25th from 3 to 5 in the theater.
Well, El Dorado, the moon is rising on another episode of Hawk Talk. I am Tony Sherg.
And I'm Kelly Hugubi. We really hope you enjoyed the show.
And if you can't get enough of Hawk Talk,
like we can't,
you can watch it at home on our YouTube channel in HD!
El Dorado's first late start will begin next Wednesday, September 30th. First period begins at 9:45. Don't show up too early, because no one will be here.